Today, topic is very important regarding this clinical practice. And this is very short topic, and I will try to finish it in very informative way so that you can restrict yourself for one species like this dog. Because topic is handling and restraining of dog. Please keep your video on. All are requested to keep your video on, please. So, handling and restraining of dog. Why handling is important? Because you people know that whenever you will approach a dog, suppose for injection, even for examination, even for any wound dressing, even for ophthalmic examination, rectal examination, skin examination, dermatological examination, any type of, suppose you are interested for taking this heart rate or even pulse rate, respiration, whatever you are interested for this clinical examination, it needs proper handling. Otherwise, if you are not able to have this handling and restraining of dog, either by owner or by yourself, then it will be very difficult to approach a dog for this type of examination. So, first of all, what is handling or restraining? You know it very well. It is just a restriction of animal activity, either by verbally, if pet owner can control his owner, his pet by verbal communication, then this is also good. Sometimes what happens when a trained dog comes to you, then it is very easy to perform this type of examination because owner is able to control his or her pet just by verbal communication. So there is no need of physical or any chemical immobilization. So if verbal communication is there, then it is very easy and it is good for animal and for your side also. So this is handling is restriction of animal's activity by verbal, physical and chemical method. Verbal, you know, physical means different type of physical entrapment is there, you know very well. I will discuss it in short. And in this lecture, mostly we will discuss about this physical method of this handling and restraining, because this is very important. Chemical immobilization, it takes another lecture, big lecture for this chemical immobilization. Any chemical immobilization means if you are going to use anesthesia, your sedative agent, or tranquilizers. So if you are going to use any anesthetics for restraining, then this is chemical immobilization, and it will be discussed when anesthesia portion will be covered. So in this lecture, I will discuss in detail about this physical method of handling and restraining. So these are the three methods most commonly used: verbal, physical, and chemical. And handling means so that the animal is prevented for injuring itself or others. Suppose if you are going to collect some blood, or you are interested for this any skin examination, or any subcut. Suppose you are going to give this subcut injection, subcutaneous any drug you are going to inject subcutaneously. Then, if animal will move, then what will happen? It will give more injury to the animal skin. Even sometimes it can injure to yours also. So this is the means that the animal is prevented from injuring itself or others. The basic principle of handling or restraining is that to prevent said physical activity, and animal is prevented from injury to others or itself. Then now discuss purpose. What are the different purposes for the restraining? Already I have discussed, it facilitates physical examination, dermatological examination, even for this recording of some parameters like heart rate, pulse rate. So for these ophthalmic examination, even also for rectum, suppose animal is having any problem in rectum and you are interested for, suppose animal is having fecalith and you are interested for enema and you are interested for rectal examination, it is not easy to perform this rectal examination very easily, even in simple animals, cooperative animals also. So try to restrain the animal, your dog properly for these type of physical examination, ophthalmic examination or rectal examination. To apply bandages, this is very important. Sometimes what happens, wound is there and you are interested for applying proper bandaging over there, because proper bandaging will prevent from infection and from self-mutilation by dog. So during this period also, you have to keep yourself safe so that you can apply bandage properly. Otherwise, if animal is not cooperative and if physical restraining and handling is not proper, then it is not possible to apply these bandages easily. Sometimes what happens, even for intramuscular injection, suppose you are interested for intramuscular injection, then it is also tough to perform this intramuscular examination, intramuscular injection in some animals. So proper handling and restraining of for this intramuscular injection is also very important. Then sometimes urinary obstruction is there, even in urethra, and you are interested for this to insert catheter, even in female bitch or even in male dog. So this female this catheterization most of the times requires some sedation. Or even if you are not going for sedation, if animal is cooperative, then it needs proper handling or restraining, because these are the critical condition. If animal will you are not going for this restraining and handling properly, then it will create problem for you also and for animal's health also. Then to prevent self-mutilation means animal, most of the times what happens, suppose a small wound is there and you are just going to keep that wound open, then what will happen? Animal try to cut that particular wound by teeth. So restraining is very important and handling is very important for to prevent self-mutilation. And to perform surgery, not for all surgery, because all surgery required a chemical immobilization, anesthesia and all the things, but some simple wound dressing, if you are interested for simple wound dressing. So sometimes plaster of Paris application also requires proper handling. So this type of things, minor surgery required, like wound dressing, POP application, and examination of some wound. So these type of things, without proper handling and understanding, it is very difficult to manage all the things. Now, these are some equipments or devices. You have already known about these things. Buccal collar, you know, by keeping the collar of the whatever collar animal is having over neck, you can control or restrain your animal properly. These are the different type of collar: buccal collar, quick release collar, nylon choke, metal sew collar, sub collar. But always be careful, and so that these collars should not be tightened in a way that it may block respiration. Or if animal will restrain and you are putting that collar tightly, and suppose the respiratory arrest is there, then animal may collapse. So always be careful while this restraining and handling, so that animals should also be safe. आपको ऐसे handling करना है कि animal की भी safety को देखते हुए आप animal को पकड़े और इतना tight पकड़ लिए कि उसकी सांस खुलने लगी, आप care नहीं किए वहां, एनिमल में, सो रेस्पिरेटरी कोलैप्स. सो ऑलवेज बी केयरफुल व्हाइल हैंडलिंग एनिमल्स ड्यूरिंग दिस टाइप ऑफ कॉलर्स. सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ कॉलर्स यूज फॉर हैंडलिंग. Now some nose leashes is also there. We have already know these are the chains, these are the leashes. Suppose you are going to put this leashes in neck and it will tighten in a way that it may interfere some or it may block respiration. So always be careful while applying these type of things during handling, because sometimes what happen during handling and some here you should be always careful by applying these things. Aapko hamesha careful rehna padega. Always monitor respiration, heart rate, always monitor status of the animal, whether animal is capable of proper respiration or not. So don't think that these things are very safe. All these leashes and collars are having advantages and disadvantages. So you should keep in mind while applying these type of leashes and collars. These are the very useful these things, and many times in our clinics here also in our clinical complex we used to apply these things for simple type of examination or simple minor. Suppose you are interested for bandaging, wound dressing. Then this is sufficient for operative animal. First, if sometimes what happens if animal is so aggressive, then it is not possible to manage by applying these also. So no doubt muzzle is very effective, and by this you can see animal is able to perform his proper respiration. Here you saw this end is open, but This one is very useful because sometimes what happens by using this, animal may open their mouth and may injure your hand, even owner. So always these muzzles are very useful. Try to apply these muzzles regularly, and suggest even owner also keep these muzzles. These are the very useful. This is also good, but these are advantage of this is animal cannot bite while. By applying these, these are the muzzles and most commonly used in routine clinical practice. Now this is very important. This is Elizabethan collar. Suppose this is very useful. Suppose animal is having wound, and I have performed this any type of surgery in abdomen. In suppose I have performed cystotomy, cystorrhaphy. Even for this you have applied wound. Wound is here in foreleg, here, or even in hind leg. Then what happens? Many times you have applied bandages and tapes and all these things. Sometimes wound is open. Then by self mutilation, animal is capable. Animal is used to make the wound in very pathetic conditions. So to prevent this self mutilation, this device is very important, because suppose you have performed this laparotomy and after 2 or 3 days when healing will start and itching is there and animal will start self mutilation, what will happen? All viscera, intestine and all this will come out, and this will be emergency situation. So if you will apply these Elizabethan collar over neck, this is very safe. Even you can apply for all the times except some fooding and all the things. Suppose the animal is going to take food, then you can open. Otherwise, it will be remain there for whatever time, 7 days, 10 days you are interested for. So this is the very good, useful things for your routine practice. And these are the different types and different sizes. For a small animal, this is small, and a bigger one is bigger. So it is available anywhere in shop. So this is very good device. Now restraining of a dog in different position. You can restrain your dog either in sitting position. Even some owners are capable to restrain their dog in a standing position also, and owner will say that no, you go for injection, it will not harm you. So agar animal owner karta hai to owner restrain karta hai, kaise karta hai I will discuss in later slide. Sometimes animal we will restrain in lateral recumbency also. Suppose you are interested for catheterization in urinary bladder, then lateral recumbency is required. Suppose you are interested for BOP application, then also lateral recumbency is required. Suppose you are interested for this blood collection, cephalic venous puncture, saphenous venous puncture, jugular venous puncture, then these all things. In all these situations, if you are interested for blood collection for any of the cephalic vein, saphenous vein, and jugular vein, then proper restraining and handling of the animal is required. You see, suppose you are interested for this any type, you are interested for examination of skin, examination of supply to record heart rate, then this handling is very useful, this type of handling. In this way, you can also restrain one hand you can put over nape and one hand below this pelvic side. And this is the also best side for restraining animal in lateral recumbency. You see one hand is here and by putting this. But this type of handling can be performed by this owner only. Because sometimes what happens, if you are not known to the animals and you are going to handle the animal in this way, then what will happen? It may bite you. Aapko ye kaat sakta hai. So this type of handling should be performed by animal owner. And you will perform whatever examination you are interested for. Suppose you are interested for examination of penis or pelvic cavity or any wound here or any tumor here. Or in dermatological examination, then owner will restrain these animals in this way. Suppose you are interested for examination, taking blood. You are interested for blood examination, blood profile examination, then you are interested for blood from cephalic vein. In four legs, which vein is there? Cephalic vein is there. So, in this way, animal may be restrained and handled, and you can collect blood from this cephalic vein. But even also here, it will be good if in this, if animal have is handling his pet in the, his or her pet in this way, then try to put muzzle here, here, because it will provide safety to you. आप क्या जानते हैं कि ये कैसा है, आपको काट भी सकता है. तो for your safety, just you put muzzle. Even the animal is, although the animal is having this type of animal owner is handling animal in this way, but it will be good if you will apply muzzle there. So keep, always remember these type of things for future and for your safety, because whenever you are interested for handling dog, first you protect yourself. And don't be, क्या कहते हैं उसको, बहुत ज्यादा उत्साहित होकर काम नहीं करना चाहिए. Be careful always. Ask to the owner about the temperament of the dog, of the pet, whether this is having this type of temperament, the animal is calm or animal is furious. And then you approach. Without knowing the temperament of the animal, if you will approach to the animal, then it will be very pathetic for you. So whenever you will come in clinics, try to follow these things very carefully. Now complications, you know very well. Complications definitely will be there if anyway you are going to restrain animal. During restraining, trauma may be there, some contusion may be there, bruising, laceration, and nerve paralysis. Suppose if animal may get injury, then it may cause this. Suppose you are interested for this intramuscular injection, and at the site of sciatic nerve you are going to inject some needle penetration towards कहीं इधर उधर अगर हुआ देन इट मे कॉज दिस एयरटिक नर्व प्रॉब्लम, मेटाबॉलिक डिस्टर्बेंसेस, स्ट्रेस में एसिडोसिस, हाइपोक्सिया, हाइपोकैल्सेमिया, हाइपरग्लाइसेमिया, hyperglycemia. Why? Because whenever you anybody needs stress, cortisol level will be higher, and these cortisol, higher cortisol level will lead to this hyperglycemia. Hyperthermia sometimes, so severe stress and struggling of animals causes this increase in temperature. Sometimes refrigeration is also there, and emotional stress is also there. So these are the some complications, minor complications, most commonly seen in the animal while restraining and handling.